now we have to see about the social forestry. Social forestry refers to the sustainable management of forests by local communities for carbon sequestration, change mitigation. Mitigation means to reduce the severity for anything, maybe pollution or anything. Depollution, deforestation, forest restoration, providing indirect employment opportunity for the youth. So that is the social forestry. Social forestry refers to the management of forest and afforestation in barren lands to the development and benefits of environment, social and rural. Forest program is done for the benefits of the people and participation of the people. The social forestry, in social forestry, trees grown outside the forest by the government and public organization that reduce pressure on forest. In order to encourage the tree cultivation outside the forest, tree cultivation in private lands was implemented in the state from 2007, 2008 to 2011 and 2012. It was implemented by carrying out block planting. What is block planting? When the vegetables are planted in blocks, that is block planting. When the plants are planted in separate areas, space, block or rows, rather than the traditional system, that is the block planting. And intercrop planting, already we have seen the intercrop planting. In between the main crops, some of the shrubs, herbs are cultivated, that is mixed cropping or intercropping or interplanting or mixed planting, etc. With profitable tree species for planting in the lands, in private lands, and creating awareness among students by giving training and camps. The tank foreshore plantation means the ground between the water's edge and cultivated land, or land along the edge of the water body, that is called tank foreshore. The part of the shore between the high water tank water mark and low water mark. So that is the tank foreshore. The tank foreshore is the main item for planting. For the tank foreshore plantation have been a major source of firewood in Tamil Nadu. There are 32 forestry extension centers which provide technical support for the growing in rural areas in Tamil Nadu. These centers provide quality trees, seedlings, saplings like thorn, thornless bamboo, cashewnuts, teak, neem tree, Malia dubia, grafted tamarind and nelly tree. These are all the things supplied by the centers. Major activities of the forest extension center, we see that. Training given for the tree growing methods. Here, in the forestry extension centers, these are all the activities given. training given for tree growing methods, number one. Number two, publicity and propaganda regarding tree growing are carried out. Number third, formation of demonstration plans. There are separate plans are allotted in order to demonstration for the growing forest trees in this method. Raising and supply of seedlings on subsidy basis, the seedlings, tree seedlings will be supplied. Awareness creation among school children and youth about the importance of forest through training and camps, etc. So these are all the major activities of the forest extension centers. So that's all about the social forestry.